What are the consequences of experimenting on the poor? My research answers this question by studying the use of randomized controlled trials for assessing success and failure in international development projects in countries from the Global South. While this type of test seemed to be quite accepted in medicine, I investigate the organizational transnational network that economists create to implement these experiments, as well as the implications of turning the real world into a laboratory. The current crisis will push the sociology of testing in many ways. As sociologists, we often still think about our research in terms of national states, but the fast ways that the virus is spreading around the world show us that we have to be more systematic about the way we think about the politics of tests transnationally. So with COVID-19, we are seeing a total lack of coordination in the global fight against the virus. The transnational institutions that could be leading the global action against the virus have been mostly absent or weak. And my hope is that if we as sociologists are able to understand the opportunities and especially the challenges involved in creating this true global action against this pandemic, we'll be in a better position to assess policymakers in the future and especially to address the global inequalities that we are seeing in the fight against the virus. My research demonstrates the inequalities and power asymmetries that exist when researchers from developed countries implement tests and evaluations in countries from the Global South. And with the COVID-19, we can already see how these global inequalities are playing. While countries that have more financial resources and better public health systems have been able to implement wide testing, even if with some delays, we haven't seen the same wide testing in countries from the Global South. So the virus so far has been quite invisible in these places. So my research stimulates us to think, how does the virus reproduce the global inequalities that we know that already exist in international networks and testing, and what can we do to address them?